Maybe wrap around two. That'd be on the play. Certainly mulliganing that one. This one's decent. I'm gonna put it on the bottom. Start with the ponder. This is pretty good. So I think I want to draw young Pyromancer this turn. So if, you know, if somehow he makes me discard a card, like he can't discard my Delver, the next turn I can play Delver, flip Gataxian Probe, and then play Pyromancer plus Probe to get a token right away. Okay, so let's see. So I want to draw Pyromancer this turn. So I want to put Probe on the bottom, then I draw Pyromancer, and the next turn I draw Delver. Yep. And then let's see. So yes, and I won't crack this fetch, obviously. Strix. Okay. I don't think I want to force something like that. I just have so many cards I can draw that just kill it. Draw Probe, and I want to cast Pyromancer and then probe him. Forcing my Pyromancer. He's got five cards left in hand. I think I'm gonna force back. Especially because I should get a token right away. Oh wow, his hand is very, very bad. Screenshot this. Doesn't even have any fetch lands. Down there for now. Alright. Actually, I guess if I wasteland him or if I use it for mana, it's the same for Angler, but let's see, what lands exactly did he have? Mountain, Swamp. Oh, he does have a fetch land. It's old bordered, so it threw me off. So let's see, I guess I should wasteland him. I'm trying to think what I could draw. I've already pitched my Vendilion Click, so that's gone. So there's really no more expensive cards left in my deck. I guess if I keep the land, I could go like Ponder into another Young Pyromancer, but I'm pretty sure I just want to play Angler next turn anyways. This, like, also just if he draws Jace, he can't Jace me this turn, so I'm gonna go ahead and wasteland him now then. So I think I want to hit this. Well, I guess he has a swamp and a mountain, so it doesn't really matter. He's probably more likely to cast two black spells in one turn. I'm not sure. Let's just try the underground sea. I don't think I want to attack, because like I said, I have so many cards that can deal with this. And if I don't draw a Lightning Bolt or something next turn, I'll attack, because I'd rather have him trade with Delver than with Angler. He might just sack that anyways. I guess I should have attacked last turn, because then this turn I could attack with Young Pyromancer. It's just so much better for me if I draw Lightning Bolt, though. There's definitely benefits to either attacking or waiting, but I think attacking might have been better, especially because I'm going to attack this turn anyways since I have Angler here. So what did he name? He named Bolt. Oh, yeah, another young Pyromancer, so... Okay, I guess I'll attack with all three of my guys now. I think I'd rather have him trade with my Pyromancer than my Delver, since I have another Pyromancer now. Yeah. So I guess it didn't matter that I attacked, since I didn't attack last turn, since he blocked my Delver anyways, but... And then I'm gonna go ahead and just cast my Angler, it's just more damage. I can save, just to ponder my graveyard for future Deathrite Shamans. I know he can't have days since I know his hand. So it's Snapcaster, three lands, Mountain, Volcanic, Polluted Delta. Mark off. We played Swamp last turn. So he might just like Snapcaster therapy me here, just to make a blocker. Colgan's Command, that's a pretty good one. So then he returned the guy to his hand. Yeah, that was really good. So now eventually he can get to, so next turn he can play that, block that. So I think I want to play my Pyromancer here, just because it's, well, it could be more damage, it could be less damage. I think it's almost for sure to be more, because even if I hit a spell on top of my library that would have flipped my Delver, it'll then be a spell that I can get a token with. So if it's like a, if it's a one, any one mana spell, I'll be able to get an extra guy, and that'll make up for the point that I miss by bricking on this. Or that if I would have flipped this, so. And if I hit a land or something, it's just an extra point of damage. Yeah, if I draw like Lightning Bolt, he's just dead. So I assume he's going to play Strix here, planning on blocking my Angler. That Colgan's Command was really good. And next turn, he can Snapcaster Colgan's Command, so he can like, he can trade with my Angler, he can trade his Strix for my Angler, Snapcaster Colgan's Command to rebuy Strix, kill young Pyromancer. Another Angler, that's not great. See, I could just not attack. Let's see, so he'll have to crack a fetch to do that. So he'll go to 7. I guess no, he still has Mountain in hand. Okay, yeah, he already used a Delta, never mind. Okay, so... So he'll be at 5, and then he'll kill my young Pyromancer and rebuy Strix, and then he'll have a blocker for one of my guys, so I can attack him with Delver, hopefully it'll flip, put him to 2, and I'll have just an elemental yet. It's not great. So if I just pass, he gets to just Snapcaster Colgan's Command, make me discard a card and kill my young Pyromancer, but then I still have a 5/5. I mean, I still have this Angler too, so I think waiting is worse. Also, this just puts more cards in my graveyard for me to be able to cast my next Angler. I guess he pretty much knows that I don't have a Lightning Bolt, because he would be dead. He might have just Colgan's Command my Delver instead. And he can wait till after I reveal something on my upkeep. But if I reveal a spell, I mean, both my Delver and my Pyromancer are good. Especially if it's like a Lightning Bolt. Because then I can just bolt his Snapcaster and hit him for 3. He's going to Brainstorm, okay. So he must have drawn something else then. He must have something else good to do, because he wouldn't. There's no way he'd brainstorm if he's if he has, you know, Snapcaster Colgan's command and nothing else. He wouldn't take that risk, at least I don't think. Okay, so Pyromancer into Strix. That's also pretty good. I really need to hit something good with this Delver here. Lightning Bolt, that was good. Okay, so I can Lightning Bolt the Strix. And then attack with everything. And he has to block my Pyromancer, and then he goes to 1. I could also just attack with these two, but it seems worse. Oh, he has a force. Okay, that's pretty good. That's very good, actually. So he gets the token too. But he had to exile the Snapcaster Mage to do that. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'll have 5 cards in my graveyard. I'll have 6 cards in my graveyard if I attack with my Pyromancer. If I do that, I also put him to 3 if he doesn't block with his Pyromancer. I think I want to do that. He's likely just going to trade Elemental for Pyromancer, Strix for Aberration. Then he goes to 3 and I get to play an Angler. So we've got 1 card left in hand. I'm guessing it's not a blue card, because he definitely would have pitched something else over Snapcaster Mage, unless it's just another Snapcaster Mage. But, So I'm pretty sure I just want to attack like this. Like I said, then I can cast my Angler, right? Because he kills both of those, yeah. I mean, it's really bad for me if he, like, chain spells here, but... I mean, I could just draw, like, a land or something, and then my Pyromancer was not doing anything anyways. I think being able to cast this an extra turn early was definitely worth it. Oh, jeez, he has another Kulgan's Command. That's pretty good. But he can't cast his Baleful Strix yet. It's not a great draw. I should need to draw another Lightning Bolt at this point. It's a Deathrite would be pretty good too, if he doesn't have a removal spell. At least if he doesn't have a spell, I get to hit him for another point here. Brainstorm. Actual counter spell. Okay, well, I guess I should have attacked first, because now he can block my elemental with his elemental. That was not great. I just can't really attack now. If I attack with my Angler, he's just going to block with his Strix. This way, at least I can hold off his team with it. Yeah, I should have attacked before that. I mean, I would have put him to 1. I'm actually not sure if putting him to 1 would have made that much difference. I could have attacked with just my Elemental. That's what I should have done. Then he couldn't fetch or anything, or he couldn't force. Alright, try it again. And this time, there's no reason to attack first. He just has elementals. Okay, well, I'll try it again. Just digging for a lightning bolt. I don't think I want to shuffle here. Or I guess, yeah, obviously I have to ponder first before I brainstorm, not ponder. Let's see. Well, I definitely don't want daze. I do kind of want this ponder. And this Cabal Therapy is not bad either. So I could take ponder this turn, draw Cabal Therapy next turn, and then cast ponder and then shuffle away the daze if I don't like it. So no, I don't want to shuffle. See, if Cabal Therapy just resolves, I'm not sure what exactly I want to name. It's either Counterspell or Force of Will, obviously. Oh, jeez, that's good. Oh, he had that in his graveyard. I forgot about that. Okay, well, he's not gonna just snipe Ponder, I'm guessing. Yeah, he named Lightning Bolt. If I had Lightning Bolt, I definitely would have left it on top of my deck, not in my hand. Which I guess I should have left Cabal Therapy in my hand for that exact reasoning, but... Okay, so I'm gonna Therapy him. But I think I'm just going to name... There's no way he has any of that stuff. And there's no way he has Colgan's Command, because he just would have... I think he would have just Colgan's Command, like, on his upkeep or whatever. Or on my upkeep, rather. What could he have? He could have his own Lightning Bolt. I think that's what I'm going to name. I must just want to see his hand, and then I can flash it back if he has a counterspell. So he did have a Lightning Bolt. But he also has a Force that he could hard cast. So I have to flash this back. I guess I have to do it now, because I don't want him to force my... I really don't want him to force my Ponder here. So I can take Deathrite Shaman. I guess I couldn't have tapped any differently. Okay, well, I mean, I'm definitely going to keep this. Next turn, I'll play Deathrite. So he has two draw steps to draw a removal spell for Deathrite Shaman. If he does have an answer to this, I get to shuffle away that daze. Yeah, Snapcaster, that's a really good one. So he can Colgan's Command, kill my Deathrite, and rebuy Baleful Strix. Pretty hard for me to win now, I think. I guess I could still just draw Lightning Bolt and him not have... I mean, he only has one Snapcaster. If he's playing four Snapcasters, he only has one Snapcaster left in his deck. So one, two... Only one Force of Will. It's probably another Counterspell, though. I guess I'm finally starting to get aggressive here. Definitely don't want to draw this daze. Or shoot, I meant to click Underground Sea, but that's okay. 4, 5, 6, 7, so I guess I'm not dead next turn. That's not great. definitely want to keep it in my hand, because if his hand is like Force of Will with no other blue cards, but yeah, something else he wants to cast, he might, you know, tap down to 5 mana to cast his other spell, and then I can Wasteland him on tap. Or if I draw Lightning Bolt, I can play Wasteland him, go to my next phase, Lightning Bolt him. Alright, well, I guess I'll pay a blue, because if he has Lightning Bolt, I don't want to die in response. Well, he doesn't have anything, so if we draw Lightning Bolt, I kill him. Nope. Alright. That was a close one. I thought I was going to win at a few points in that game, but... So I think I definitely want Jits. Painful Truth seems good. Dark Blast seems great. I think that's it. Let's see. I don't love all of my forces in this matchup. It's just a... You know, basically fair matchup. I'm trying to grind him out and bring him stuff like Painful Truth, so I don't want, you know, these 2-for-1s, or 1-for-2s, rather. I don't think I want Dismember. Spell Pierce is probably not great either. Definitely want Lightning Bolts. Yeah, I'm going to cut a Spell Pierce. I'm going to go first. This hand's okay. I think I'm going to keep. Between Therapy, Dark Blast, and Delver, I have a lot of Disruption, and then Force. Like, either I'll flip my Delver early on, and, you know, hopefully it'll just, like, with a Brainstorm or Ponder or something, or I won't flip it and it'll be a land. I mean, obviously there's some things other than those two that could happen, but... Those are the two most likely scenarios, and either one of those is fine. I'll play my Delver first. I have to decide if I want to force a removal spell or not. I think I do. Okay. Therapy, alright. I'm not sure what he's going to name here. Maybe My Therapy? And Pyromancer, sure. Let's see, so I could name... I don't think I want to... I definitely don't want to name Pyromancer against him since I have this Dark Blast. We'll see what I draw here. Cataxian Pro, well that's perfect. Alright, so he's in the same spot as me with no land. He has another probe though. But he has no blue source. So this Ponder doesn't do much. Okay. I think I just... Let's see, let me pull up his hand here. I think I want to name Baleful Strix. It's the only card that I really care about all that much. Like, he's going to probe me, and then if he draws a land and ponders... That's fine. I have Dark Blast for the Young Pyromancer. I guess I have Dark Blast for Baleful Strix too. I could just name Ponder with my Therapy. I could just name Probe, actually. And then if he draws a blue source, just forces Ponder. Yeah, I think I'm going to just name Probe. Because if he misses for, like, you know, 2 turns, I think that's going to put me enough ahead to win. Okay, well, unfortunately he didn't miss at all, but Let's see. So his hand again is I definitely don't want to force the ponder because he just has Snapcaster Mage. And same with Baleful Strix. I can just Dark Blast it. I'm gonna save this force for a removal spell. Just kind of protect this Delver at all costs. Baseline, that was a good draw. Dark Blast this. I guess I should have played Wasteland in case he has. I mean, there's no way a deck like his has Days in it, but there's just no reason not to play it first. Okay. Baleful Strix. That's somewhat unfortunate. To me, he's going to take my Force, most likely. Yeah. That's fine. Now I just need to fade a removal spell. I mean, he's only got a few draw steps till he's just dead. Oh, well, I guess that was good. And, you know, stuff. Something like Baleful Strix doesn't do it because I have the Stark Blast in my graveyard, so. Not the best land. I mean, if he misses one more time and then I hit him, like, just at any point in the game, draw a red source and very likely kill him with Bolt plus Force. Murderous Cut, definitely forcing that. And there's a red source. Alright, that was an interesting game. I could take out like a Daze or two on the draw. Maybe for like, these therapies might be really good. Could also maybe bring in an extra force or two. I think I'm just going to cut one Daze for one therapy. Sounds pretty good. Start off with the probe. So I'll play my land first in case he dazes. Like I said, there's no way he has daze, but I'm gonna play that land anyways. Okay. So, ooh, that was lucky. I seem to be doing that a lot lately. So I could therapy his young Pyromancer, which then lets him probe and therapy me. I could also therapy his Gitaxian probe. That doesn't seem great. I could also just play Deathrite Shaman. So if I just play Deathrite Shaman, then he's going to go, most likely, Volcanic Island young Pyromancer, probe you, which is fine. And then on my turn, I can... See, I really want to resolve this Jit before he gets the chance to therapy it, so that on my turn I could just play like Delver Jit. But then I basically don't get to use this therapy at all. I think I just want to therapy young Pyromancer here. The next turn I just get to play Delver Deathrite. That does let him therapy my Jit, but I think that's okay. I'm just pretty far ahead that it's fine. I imagine he's going to therapy jet, but we'll see. Brainstorm was a decent draw from him. So he's likely putting back this swamp, I would guess. So we know he used Cataxian Probe. And that's gone. Just gonna close this. It's pretty unreliable now that he brainstormed, so. So, there's the therapy. He named Deathrite Shaman, so not Jit. Okay. So I guess I'm just going to ponder and then play Volcanic Island, Delver of Secrets. I'm definitely going to keep this Daze, too. So I want to put Delver, Lightning Bolt, Daze, and I can flip Delver with my Bolt. It's unfortunate if he just has a lightning bolt for this, then I'm drawing that bolt instead of the Delver, but hopefully if he has removal spells like Kolgan's Command, that would be pretty good right now, because Kolgan's Command would be pretty good from his side. I mean, he's seen my hand, I didn't have any counterspells last turn, and he can return that Young Pyromancer Blood Moon. Jeez, I'm definitely counterspelling that. Yeah. Didn't expect that. He might have a force or something here. No, okay, good. Yeah, I'm just gonna play Jit. It's better to blow up his Volcanic. So, let's see. I guess I closed that window already, but we don't really know any of the three cards in his hand. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and blow up his Volcanic. See, he could just not have another red source. But he didn't know that I had Wasteland, so he probably has another one. So yeah, I think that's next turn I'm going to play Jit. So I have Delver on top of my deck. Yeah, I'm going to play Jit, and the next turn I can equip Jit and play the other Delver. I mean, unless he, of course, kills this Delver, then I just have to play my other Delver. Fork Bolt, yeah. Okay. Like a Brainstorm or Ponder would be nice. Or just another Lightning Bolt and put him close to dead. If he has another removal spell for this, it's not looking great for me. Then I need to draw a creature. Pyromancer, that's okay, I can beat that. Ugh, and a murderous cut, that's not good. I'm gonna bolt this in case he has like a probe or something. He's only got one card left, so if I just draw a creature, I should be in good shape. Like, Angler would be insane. Okay, he's gonna hit my Jit, that makes sense. Yeah. Okay, well, so now we're just both have nothing. Deathrite, that's good. Strix is decent. Dark Blast. Yeah, that's okay. I'm just gonna start exiling cards from this graveyard. I'll start with Forked Bolt. Rather, no, Murders could be better, because he can't Snapcast or Forked Bolt me. Yeah, I'm just going to take that. I'd rather save this Dark Blast. I mean, I know I can just dredge it, but I'd rather have a draw step rather than just take one a turn. Save this for, like, a Young Pyromancer or something. See, I'm going to take Murderous Cut. I should have did Murderous Cut on my turn. No, but then he could just Snapcast with a Fork Bolt, so... Jeez, if he drew Snapcast, that's so bad for me. Ugh. I mean, it's not that bad. I get to kill it, but he just gets to kill my Deathrite. He had to have Snapcaster that turn, because if I untap, everything else in his graveyard is sorcery speed, so I can just respond to Snapcaster with it. Also sucks that he just doesn't take two now. I could Dark Blast that, but I think I want to save my fetch land in case I draw Brainstorm. I'm going to do this now. That's not good. I still should have Deathrite Shaman on my turn, because then I could have exiled the Fork Bolt as well. I mean, he would have had to flash back the Fork Bolt, rather. So I would have dealt 2 damage. Well, now I just can't possibly win. I could have dealt 2 damage and exiled both of his cards. Yeah, even if I draw my other 2 lightning bolts, it's only 9 damage. I just can't cast any spells left in my library. Yeah, I'm just going to concede. Alright, next match.